Hey everybody, sorry about this video being out late today. I was really hoping that they would release all this stuff on Tuesday, which they normally do, but instead they revealed it today while I was in LA with Macy J, Oh My God It's Priest, Get Flanked, and your boy Roy. Now I'm sure you guys all know who they are, but there's a link to their channels in the description below. Go check them out, go subscribe, go support them because they're awesome dudes. Now we got a chance to check out the new documentary called To Win It All, which is a video featuring Canadian from EG, Pengu from G2, and Zig from Team Liquid. It shares some personal stories about them, and if you like the esports scene for Siege, then you'll definitely enjoy this. I know it's playing in some theaters like around the United States. You guys should definitely check it out. Anyways, let's go ahead and talk about the video. Ubisoft released a brand new playlist on us today called The Road to SI. Now, if you guys don't know what that is, basically it's the 6th Invitational. Next month, there's going to be a $1 million prize pool where a bunch of teams are going to be facing off from around the world to get it. I'd like to know who you guys think is going to win this. Let me know in the comments below. So basically, the new playlist is a pick and ban system that was created by Ubisoft Barcelona last year. It's only been used by the ESL Pro League custom games, but Ubisoft wanted to do a test to see how responsive the community is toward the new game mode. But is it what the game really needs? Well, we're going to be talking about it in today's video. Let's go!
All together now?
Got it.
Okay. Haphazard entry, but an immediate refrag.
Let's go.
The killing will start. Oh, no! Another body goes down.
1v1, you can do this.
You know
Careful.
That a couple bullets right,
yes.
And you
run
it. Yes, yes, yes.
Man, Ubisoft is stepping up their game with these videos, huh? Anyways, where was I? Currently, Siege has two different playlists to queue for. You have Casual, which is basically a 4-minute time mode where anything goes. You cannot select your objective or spawn points, but you do have the option to pick all the available operators. There is a hidden MMR system that tries to keep higher skilled players in their own category, but we all know that can fail sometimes. Casual is a best of three, so whoever wins 2 rounds is proclaimed the victor. All maps are available in Casual except for Bartley University, which I'm totally okay with. If you guys didn't like that map, make sure you leave a like to show me. Now the other only multiplayer option that you can queue for is ranked, which you're able to select your objective sites and spawn locations. All the operators are available to play, and the round timer drops from 4 minutes to 3, which I think it should stay like that, to be honest. It has its own MMR system that also keeps you within your rank, so you can't really face extremely low players if you're a diamond. So to win a ranked game, you have to win 4 times, or 5 if the opponent wins 3 rounds against you. Ranked has excluded maps in this playlist, which are Tower, House, Favela, Bartlett, and Yacht. Did I trigger you by not putting those in alphabetical order? Now both Casual and Ranked have a 4-second diffuser timer, so you can plant and diffuse really quickly. Well, now Ubisoft wants to test a third option, which may or not replace the current rank system in the future, which I really hope it does. I'm so excited. I do want to clarify that there hasn't been any information on this, but it is a high possibility if the community wants it. The new playlist mirrors the current pro settings, except for there's no 6th pick. The 6th pick essentially adds another level of thinking to the game. In the Pro League, it shows who your enemies chose and it allows you to pick one of your operators to be replaced. For example, let's say you notice that the enemy picked a Montaigne and your team realized that they don't have a Legion to counter him, so you swap one of your current selected operators before the round starts with a Legion. Now let's say that you know that they're going to 6th pick a Legion to counter the Montaigne, then you can swap one of your operators to get an IQ to counter the Legion. So there's a whole bunch of crazy mind games behind it. Your team only gets one of these per round, so it adds another level of complexity. But this feature is not included in the new playlist, and quite frankly, it's a little bit too much anyways. So the only maps that are approved on this new playlist is Bank, Border, Clubhouse, Coastline, Consulate, Oregon, and Villa. Nighttime is not included due to the difficulty in seeing enemies in some maps. You get to be an attacker or defender 3 times in a row, and then you swap roles until you win. So it's essentially 3-3-3-3, and it keeps going on until you win. Now in the Pro League, it's actually 5, so they lessened it down, so it's not crazy. All spawn and site locations can be picked, but not all operators are available for selection. At the beginning of the game, you and your team will select an attacker and a defender to ban while your opponents do the exact same thing. You have 30 seconds and each player must pick an operator, and whichever operator has the most picks gets the ban. Let's say you're going to be an attacker for the first 3 rounds and you don't really want to face a Mira on Oregon on the bottom floor. So then your whole team selects Mira, she gets banned and nobody can play it. This will make an easier attack round for you, but you have to be careful too because you won't be able to use Mira once the roles are swapped. So if you really dislike an operator, you and your team can completely remove it from the match because the bans stick until the game is over. It's a fantastic feature that allows players to use different strategies. The HUD option stays the same, just like in casual and ranked. You get to see somebody when they're injured or you hurt somebody or a Jaeger device goes off. However, kill cams are removed. Now here's a big one. The plant time is extended to 7 seconds instead of 4. Because the new playlist system only has bomb, you cannot play secure area or hostage in it, which is perfectly fine by me. Now personally, I love this new playlist and I would really like to see it in ranked. I feel that Siege should be played at the highest settings like this. Certain operators become extremely good with these new settings like smoke. Now you'll be finding yourself having a harder time planting the diffuser against the smoke because it takes you longer and you'll eventually succumb to the toxic babes while planting. Currently, Lion, Kaid, and Nomad are not in the pro league because they haven't been approved, but they are in this new playlist. Well, this has been confirmed by Ubisoft. It does take the hidden casual MMR and it implements it into the new playlist. So it's used to calculate who you play against in the new road to SI. But there's a really good chance that you might run into really good players because they haven't been calibrated yet. Now, if you get a chance to try this, I highly recommend it. This is our chance to show Ubisoft that we want things like this in our game. Casual's gotta go or at least be tweaked, and this is a step in the right direction. I think this new playlist should replace ranked, and the ranked settings should replace the casual settings. Although I do still think that casual should be a best of three to make games faster for alpha pack earnings. You also get more renown for playing the new game mode too, which is really nice since the games are longer. Speaking of alpha packs, I know you guys love the skins, and Ubisoft released a new alpha pack that contains these operators here. I absolutely love these skins as they show more of a casual approach to their gear. You can get them here for 6,000 credits, which is like $40, I think that's how much I spent. You also get a free one via this challenge right here, so make sure you guys log in and try to get that. These alpha packs include a universal weapon skin, headgear, uniforms, and charms, which you've been watching me open these for the past few minutes. Now going back to the beginning of the video where I said that there's a possibility that the new invitational prize pool will be increased to 2 million, well, 30% of all the proceeds to the alpha packs will go directly to that prize pool, which is really nice because of the bigger prize pool, it's going to attract more professional players. It's going to make the scene a lot bigger. I absolutely love this idea. Dota 2 kind of does like a compendium kind of thing where you get like skins and stuff if you help support the esports scene there. And the prize pool just gets like abnormally large and the viewership is just like absolutely crazy. So again, it's a really good thing for the game. Now the new playlist is available from January 25th to February 18th if you want to go ahead and try that out. Anyways, that's it for today's video. Sorry for being late. I just got home. Leave a like if you guys enjoyed today's content, and I will see you guys in the next video.
Bye-bye.